Hi, I'm Cosmic Scale, the developer behind the PSBBN Definitive English Patch. I'm here today to share a big update. The complaints I hear most about PSBBN is the storage limit being only 128GB and the difficulty of installing games. PSBBN Definitive English Patch 2.0 addresses both of those issues. It now supports drives up to 128PB and 700 games. This is PSBBN running on a PlayStation 2 with a 1TB SSD and 200 games. As you can see, the menu is very responsive and the artwork loads fast. And all the games are listed alphabetically and grouped by series. A good example of that is the GTA games. As you can see, they're grouped in order of release. You can also scroll through the games quickly. When you stop, the artwork soon catches up. You can add shortcuts for up to 4 games. That's very handy when you've got a lot of games installed. Press select anywhere to access the shortcut menu. Now let's head over to the music channel. As we've got so much space now, we can have a larger music partition. It was capped at 5GB and you could store around 7 albums. It can now be up to 97GB, allowing for around 150 albums. So how does all this work? The answer is APA Jam. Developed by Burion over at PSX Place, it allows the PlayStation 2's APA partitions to coexist with an exFAT partition. This setup allows PSBBN to access the first 128GB on the drive directly. The remaining space on the drive is formatted as an exFAT partition. The exFAT partition can be accessed directly on a PC and by a custom version of OPL on the PlayStation 2. PS2 games are stored on the exFAT partition. I wrote an app called OPL Launcher BDM, and that app resides on the APA partitions and tells OPL what game to launch from the exFAT partition. There are other new features like wLaunchELF is now pre-installed. There's new online channels for Bandai and SCEI. Also, a lot of people were asking about the Linux dual boot, and that is now included. You just hold any button on the controller at startup and it will boot into Sony's official Linux kit. But we haven't got time to talk about all that today. We're going to focus on two things: the new PSBBN installer and the game installer. Let's start with what you'll need: a fat PlayStation 2 console, an official Sony network adapter, preferably a SATA conversion kit, a hard drive or SSD over 130GB. Ideally an SSD over 500GB, I recommend this one. You also need a way to connect the drive to your PC. The scripts require Linux. I recommend Linux Mint. If you don't have a Linux install on your computer, you can either create a live USB to boot from or use a virtual machine. Let's head over to the desktop and I'll show you how it works. Okay, the first thing you need to do is launch your favorite web browser and go to github.com/cosmicscale. Then you need to click on the PSBBN Definitive English Patch. You can have a look at the README, but we are interested in the download link. So click on code. Click here to get the URL copied to the clipboard. Now you can just close the web browser and launch the terminal. Type git clone, then paste in the URL and hit return, and it's downloading now. Right, that's done, so you can close the terminal. I won't be asking you to type any more commands. Right, now we can double click on the PSBBN Definitive English Patch folder and in here you will find three scripts. First of all, we need to run the setup script, so double click that, click run in terminal. This script installs all dependencies required for the PSBBN installer and game installer. It must be run first. Press any key to continue. So let's just press any key and wait for that to run. That will take a little while, so I will be back with you shortly. Okay, with the setup script done, next is the PSBBN installer. But first, make sure your PlayStation 2 hard drive is connected to your PC, either via USB or internally. Just make sure it's connected. Then we can double click on the PSBBN installer. And again, click run in terminal. Now here you will find a list of all the drives connected to your computer. I've got quite a few. But from this list, we've got to find the PlayStation 2 drive. Now, I know mine is the Kingston 240G, so that is /dev/SDE. So let's type that /dev/SDE and press return. Are you sure you want to write to /dev/SDE? This will erase all data on the drive. So double check, make sure you've got the right drive, and then type yes and hit return. Then it checks for the latest version of the PSBBN Definitive patch. And if it doesn't find it stored locally, it downloads it from the Internet Archive. So now you just gotta wait for the download. And that will take a little while, so I will be back when that's done. Okay, the download's almost complete. Another few more seconds. Okay, and then it downloads the POPs binaries of the Internet Archive. Right. Now we are writing the PSBBN disk image, and that takes around 20 minutes, so I will be back. Okay, so now the image has been written to the disk and verified, we gotta set up the partitions on the first 128 gig of the drive. The first thing you need to do is decide how many games you'd like to install. So let's just read this bit. OPL launcher partitions are used to launch games from the game channel. Consider how many games you want to install and plan for future expansion. Additional OPL launcher partitions cannot be created after setup. Note, the more partitions you create, the longer it will take to load the game list. Fewer OPL launcher partitions leaves more space for the music partition and the POPs partition for PS1 games. A good starting point is 200 partitions, but feel free to experiment. Now, 200 games takes about 10 seconds for the games list to load. 700 games takes about 40 plus seconds. And like I said, you want to allow space for the other two partitions too. So let's stick with 200. So type 200 and press return. What size would you like the music partition to be? Remaining space will be allocated to the POPs partition for PS1 games. The minimum is 10, the available space is 72. Let's go for 30 and press return. Right, 52 gigs are allocated to POPs. It's now creating 200 OPL launcher partitions. That may take a while. Okay, now it's modifying the headers of those 200 partitions to make them bootable. Now it's making res folders for all the game assets, like the artwork. It's installed POPs and OPL. Now it's running APA JAL and formatting the rest of the drive as exFAT. And that's it, it's all completed. So just press any key to exit, and we're done. Okay, let's get some games installed. In the folder of all the scripts, you'll find a games folder, and this is where your games go. If you're familiar with OPL, you'll know what to do, but PS2 CD-based games go in the CD folder, PS2 DVD-based games go in the DVD folder, and PlayStation 1 games go in the POPs folder. If you've got your games stored in a different location, like I have, then there's some extra steps, and I'll show you what you need to do. Let's just open up the location of my games. There they are. Okay, you can see our CD, DVD, and POPs folder here. Let's just have a look in the DVD folder. You can see we've got ISO files, we've got ZSO files, we've got games that start with the game ID and games that don't. Like, the file name and format doesn't matter, the script deals with all of that. If you look in the POPs folder, all PS1 games need to be in the VCD format. So that's all the games we're going to be installing that I've got ready. Okay, now if you right click on the games folder and say copy, and then come back over here and double click on the game installer and click display, then here you will find modify this path if your games are stored in a different location. So if you get rid of that and paste in the new path where my games are, and then do file, save, and close that, we are now ready to run the game installer script. And like I say, that's only necessary if your games are in a different folder than this one. Okay, let's double click on the games installer again and click run in terminal. Right, then we get this screen. Now we need to type in the device name for our PS2 hard drive. It's easier to spot now because you will see a recovery and an OPL partition on it. So, and if you remember from last time, it's /dev/SDE. So if we type that in, /dev/SDE, and hit return. Right, that's creating a list of all our games. It's found a ZSO file without a game ID in the file name. So it has to decompress it, extract the game ID, and then what it will do, it will rename the file. So then next time when this process runs, it won't need to decompress and get the game ID that way again, because this does take a little time. So if all your files are ISO, there won't be any waiting. Okay, that's the game list created. We've got 43 games to install. There's 200 partitions. All the partitions are present, so we are ready to install. So let's just press any button. Now it's syncing the PlayStation 1 games to the PlayStation 2 hard drive. It's now syncing the PlayStation 2 games to the PlayStation hard drive. Okay, that's all the games synced. We're unmounting the OPL partition. Okay, now we're getting ready to download the artwork. and we are grabbing the artwork from IGN because we needed swear artwork for PSBBN, and this was the only real resource I could find of swear PlayStation 2 artwork. The script actually works really well. I'd say it gets about 95% of the artwork. I did originally consider using the OPL art database, but if the artwork isn't fully optimized for PSBBN and you are installing hundreds of games, the performance is so bad. So the artwork really needs to be square, needs to be 256 by 256 pixels, and needs to have an 8-bit color depth. So this is the way we're doing artwork. Now it's converting the downloaded artwork to a format that PSBBN likes. And now it's creating the game assets and installing them, and the script is complete. Now you just press any key and it's done. So as you can see, the game install process is fully automated now. Right, we are left with a couple of log files, especially the missing art log. If I double click on that. Okay, so there was two games that the script was unable to download artwork for. Now, I would appreciate it if you use this and you have missing artwork to submit this as an issue on the GitHub, and I can fix the missing arts that way. Also, if you look in the icons folder, you've got an art folder, and that is now filled of all the artwork that was downloaded. I don't know how yet, but I would like people to contribute their art folder too, so we can build our own collection and not have to download everything off IGN. And if you want to add or remove games in the future, all you need to do is go to your games folder and just either remove games or add games to here, and then just rerun the game installer script. It's that simple. Okay, let's put this drive back in the PS2 and see what we've got. Okay, with the drive back in the PlayStation 2 and the PlayStation 2 booted, let's head over to the game channel. Now the games list is going to take around 10 seconds to load, so let's wait for that. You may notice that when you're scrolling through the games list for the first time, it's a bit laggy and the artwork doesn't load quickly. All you have to do is scroll all the way through the games right to the end, and that gives PSBBN time to cache all the artwork. Then when you quit to the top menu and come to the games list again, it all loads fine and everything's smooth. It's only that first time. Before launching a game, make sure there's no other BDM devices connected to your PS2, like a USB drive, iLink, or the MX4 ISO. If you scroll right to the end and load one of the coming soon empty game spaces, it launches OPL. I hope you found this video useful and you'll give the PSBBN Definitive English Patch 2.0 a try. If you want to see what else PSBBN can do, you can check out my other video, PSBBN in 2024. But that's it for today. Until next time, Cosmic Scout signing out.